Fuck it, we're doing the finale right now.
Holy crap.
Fuck it, we're doing live!
Not produces any... What the hell is that? Okay, apparently the judge turned black for a second. I don't know what happened. I guess Hodgepodge got a blue fuse there.
I didn't notice anything.
Oh well, maybe it's just my player.
Yeah, I don't even know.
We just heard proof that does not exist!
I realize
that, Your Honor. I swear to drunk, I'm not God.
I'm not as thick as you drunk I am.
Well, it seems to be the officer problem.
That is probably the best.
The murderer, of course.
Any South Park episode ever.
The murderer? Then tell us, just who is this murderer? Is it freaking Cartman? Is that what you think it is? I'm still thinking about that one.
Hey! Screw you guys, I'm gonna him! Screw you guys!
Him.
That you sounded like a mouse trying to.
I can't do his voice, sue me.
I can't do it either. Where is there for some pressing knee, the murderer took the to search for a black bullet?
Nah, really?
No, he didn't need it. Why would the murderer have spent the time to look for that stray bullet? I haven't got a clue!
Ouch.
I'll just headbutt my desk until I get something! It's like... I'm getting it!
Don't worry, hang on!
Shit!
Had to take it. ...
Hmm?
Hey, Mia! Stop being vague!
Seriously? There you go.
You're thinking too normal. Think crazy. Don't think why the bullet was taken. Think why the bullet had to be taken.
Thank you, Mia! Finally!
Though it's still pretty fucking vague.
Nuts!
Yeah.
That's more information than what you were saying before.
I have no idea what I'm doing. I like that one line. It's like, yeah, I'm ready. I have no idea what I'm doing.
No idea what's
going on. The
murderer
had to take the bullet.
What do you mean?
The murderer had to take the bullet.
For instance,
yeah, it what?
Maybe the bullet hit the murderer.
What?
Just saying. For instance.
Say for instance. I mean, if it hit you, you'd have to take it with you, wouldn't you? Huh? It's not like you couldn't perform surgery right there. Huh? You know what I mean?
I mean, this is Phoenix Wright. This isn't Trauma Center.
This is a Trauma Center. We'd be involved. There would be a bomb involved.
That was only one case, and it had nothing to do with a patient. It was just a bomb, and a surgeon was on the scene at the time.
Let me get this straight. So at the time of the murderer himself was shot, and he left with the second bullet still inside. Thus leaving only one bullet at the scene of the crime.
Well, yes.
Yeah, I guess that's how it works. Yeah. There's a problem with that. The other two people rescued from the elevator. Miles Edgeworth and Yanni Yogi, they were both unharmed. So that would mean... ... The murderer came from outside, yes.
Holy
shit.
Even though he's really...
Phoenix's bluffing is actually working. Again.
And Miles
His bluff is actually true, actually.
And Edward's just sitting there, is like, what the fuck is he talking about?
I think that's how everyone's thinking right now. You just imagine the people in the audience going, what the fuck is happening right now?
And Larry's like, something awesome.
Oh, I forgot Larry is there.
Yeah.
I completely forgot Larry was here.
Just Larry in the crowd with a bunch of popcorn. He's like, this is getting good.
Yeah. Like, where'd you get the poker from? Because I understand. You know, he bought it from Samurai Dogs.
Oh, goddamn.
Samurai Tacos or whatever. Now you just see him munching on a taco.
And then Paco's there too for some fucking reason. We're like, yeah.
Little did they know that the real hero of the story was King Paco.
Was Paco. Yes.
Deny it! Deny it!
What are you saying? Deny it, you piece of shit! No one's involved in the incident when they did! No, don't murder her! What the fuck's wrong with you?
Based on that outburst, Mr. Von Karma, I'd have to agree that you're fucking insane!
I'm not crazy! You're crazy! Especially you, but Ghost of Patrick!
Why Ghost Patrick?
I don't know. Remember what Mr. Grossberg said yesterday? Gregory Edward dealt a blow to his perfect trial record.
Oh,
wow.
And by the way, while I'm in this flashback, how's your backlog coming along, Logic?
It's getting better.
You managed to beat Xenoblade Chronicles after about a year. That's a good start.
But then I pre-ordered Tales of Exilia 2 and Smash Brothers for the 3DS.
That's pre-orders, those don't count.
God damn it, Logic, your backlog's growing so higher than my freaking chest hair.
Those are pre-orders, the games don't exist yet, that doesn't count.
He took it because he was injured.
Dun dun dun.
Which would mean, dot dot dot, it could only mean one thing. I knew it! He went out of town!
Fuck.
He went out of town to get McDonald's! I knew it!
But there's a McDonald's 5 minutes down the road.
Not that one.
That one has terrible service.
God damn it. Oh, wait.
They don't serve the McChicken sandwiches he likes.
Oh, wait. No. Grossberg would still have to be working on your backlog because you also have to finish Bravely Default now.
No, even I wouldn't finish that.
I have Bravely Default, I still gotta finish Dream Team, which I am really close to beating.
How have you not finished Dream Team yet? That game's been out for 2 years!
It's only been out 1 year.
Well, granted, it took me a while to finish.
Well, it's almost been 2 years.
Well, this is certainly interesting news. Very well, Mr. Wright. Who is your suspect? Dot dot dot. Yeah, who is your suspect? Vagina! Yeah, V1! V1! V1!
My what?
I like how he smiles and just like, aw, shit.
That's that rapist smile.
Yeah, he's all like, this motherfucker.
The Yvonne Kama, the prosecutor, sitting right there.
Yes.
Bah! Bah! You don't object? I see no need. Why honor this ridiculous outburst with my objection? Because you took a vacation for several months starting the day after the incident. You obviously went to Anime Man Atlantic that 1 year, yet you pride yourself on a perfect record.
Fuck!
Why would you take this long vacation without any reason? I had a reason. I kinda wanted to attend a... Is it wrong to attend a con, Mr. Wright?
Yes.
It is when you dress like evil George Washington.
Yeah. It's like, I'm not dressed like evil George Washington, I am evil George Washington.
Yeah, bring in George Washington, I'll prove it.
But he's dead.
But Von Karma, he's dead. Then bring in a drawing.
Dig up
bring
his
me
grave.
His corpse.
It's a skull. Fuck you.
I know Von Karma, perhaps too well. He's perfect. He wouldn't leave clues.
Oh, everybody, really?
Well, he probably didn't undergo surgery. That would leave a doctor as a witness.
Yep. Nobody's that perfect!
You know, on hindsight, I should have inserted that one courage clip. You're not perfect. You're not perfect. No, he couldn't have. You can't just pull bullets out of
Speaking
yourself.
Speaking of drunk, that face that Maya makes always makes her look drunk.
Wait a minute.
What does that mean? That bullet has to be somewhere, but where? I'm surprised we haven't connected the dots yet.
Huh?
I mean, it's shoving it right in your face. Seriously.
Oh, shit. I know how you like it so much.
What? The evidence that proves Von Karma was shot.
The metal... Goddamn... Oh my god! Oh my god, Larry actually did something good for once. That dumbass actually did something right for once.
No, that's Maya. Oh. I had the ball.
Oh, that's
Larry.
Right. Never mind, Larry. You still suck.
Oh, poor Larry. This is getting crazy.
Well, that's not true. He did have that one little outburst at the very beginning of the case that kind of helped you.
One way to find out.
That still has a point on, by the way. That piece of shit.
I'm gonna run this over you and see what we find. That sounds wrong. Imagine if it was a car. It's like, I'm gonna run this over you. Oh god, please no.
Sprite change! That means we're getting somewhere!
It finally has a different expression. It's only taken us 5 parts.
And man, his teeth creep me out like that.
That's true.
He looks more like Dracula in that pose.
He does. It's like, oh god, don't make me shoot fireballs at you. I'll have to teleport then, and you don't want me to do that.
Man, I call for respect really in the trial crazy. And an invasion of privacy for Iron Man for Drunk Karma. Statute of limitations runs on this case today. It was you who said we had to end it right here, right now, didn't it? Wasn't it?
Fuck you!
Yeah. I permit the use of the metal detector. Mr. Von Karma, you will submit yourself to testing. For makeup testing.
Aww, oh shit.
Not only are we gonna convict you of murder, we're also gonna humiliate you in front of this entire courtroom.
Well, shit. You know, they missed a perfectly good opportunity to make this a minigame.
Nah, that'd be completely
even
pointless.
In the DS version, you could have used the stylus.
It would have been completely pointless.
It would have been interesting, to say the least.
Not really.
So you.
You. It was you.
You. Disgust me.
No, it's like a Deadpool. You. Me.
God damn it.
Yeah. Indeed, there is a bullet in my shoulder, see? However, it has nothing to do with this incident.
Bullshit.
Indeed.
You fucking liar.
Long before the DL6 incident.
I claim that a bullet in my shoulder has no relation to DL6.
Then why would you go out of your way to not get surgery for it? I mean, who the fuck would shoot you outside of a case like that?
That's what I was gonna ask. If it wasn't involved in DL6, who the fuck would have shot you?
Why wouldn't you get surgery for it?
Dick Cheney.
Dick Cheney!
Not as you have to prove it, not I. No, why do I have to do all the work for you?
Maybe he's secretly training you to be his next disciple.
No. Of course he can't. You don't have any of the DL6 evidence. Because I'm a...
Because I stole it.
That's because you took it out of the record room yesterday. Tis, I wave my finger at you. With no proof, you cannot convict me of any crime. So sorry, Mr. Wright.
Also sorry I tased you the other day. I mean...
I'm the one who's sorry, Mr. Von Karma.
Oh, shit.
I'm in the middle of a speech here.
You're one day away from retirement. Freedom.
I'll get shot one day before retirement. Literally.
Who would have thought you would have done your own grave trying to convict Edward? I can link that bullet in your shoulder to the DL6 incident, no problem.
My final proof.
Oh, yeah.
Here's my final proof. A gun! Oh, kind of.
The bullet, bullet from a gun.
Where did you get that? Ow, my throat. The bullet used in DL6 incident is taken from the heart of the victim, Mr. Gregory Edward. Done by someone named Deke. I'm not sure where it came from.
How did they preserve a bullet that for that long?
Oh, they can do that. It's not that hard.
True.
Yeah. It is metal. I mean, if it were, like, more organic, then it'd be pretty impossible.
Yeah, but I mean...
And now we can recap for ballistic markings.
Yeah, that's true.
Because Maya was too stupid enough to realize
assuming ballistic markings last for 5 years.
They can.
That's true.
We have 2 bullets in our possession. One, the bullet removed from Gertrude Edwards' heart. The other, Mr. Von Karma, is the bullet buried in your shoulder.
See?
We could analyze both bullets. Then, if the markings matched, we would know that both bullets have been fired from the same gun. The very same pistol. In other words, the murder weapon that killed Gregory Edgeworth.
Oh, crap. Karma?
He's losing it.
I think he's gonna have a heart attack.
You will let us remove the bullet from your shoulder.
Then we'll compare the ballistic markings to those on this bullet. And solve this case once and for all. I'm Morgan Freeman, and my voice is terrible.
Oh, god.
Here it goes. Yes! the best breakdown ever.
Yeah. That scream.
That scream, I heard it before. It sounds like someone online.
Shit.
Wait, I know. I can't breathe. I have googly eyes. I said, quiet. You're not making this any easier. Stop breathing my air. Rah, 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 rah. Stop, I need my... We need oxygen, even though there's plenty of air in this one little room. We're not shut tight.
Well,
We're not shut tight enough to lose air.
Well, it's never really explained exactly how long they were trapped in the elevator. If you're stuck in a broken down elevator for like 2.5 hours, then yeah, you'd probably start losing air.
Well, for that long, maybe, yeah.
I mean, like, not enough air would be coming in to, like, sustain you. I mean, even though there are, like, holes here and there, it's not enough to, like, keep fresh air coming
maybe
in.
Maybe
Von Kramer. Wow, he's still going. Damn, he has one hell of a voice box.
God damn.
I just stabbed myself. Ow, ow, ow.
I will break
this
wall.
Why do I keep doing this to myself? Why do I keep doing this to myself? Ow! 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 Ow!
I like how he just obviously threatens Edgeworth with death. He's like, I will fucking bury you.
Everyone already knows that he did it now.
Yeah, at this point.
I'm not gonna lie, this music kind of creeps me out.
Why? It's supposed to make you feel sad.
Well, when it's Von Karma talking, like, you shouldn't feel bad for Von Karma. He's an asshole.
Meh.
He was an asshole even before he lost his perfect record.
Meh. Me? Penalized? Of course I was penalized, because I'm a douchebag.
You don't even have to play Ace Attorney Investigations to know that he's an asshole.
Nah. Well, granted, he's not an asshole in that one, because it's not as obvious. It was pitch black. The light's supposed to have gone out. I went out in the hall and felt my way to the elevator.
I never did play Investigations.
Apparently, my eyes can't adjust to darkness.
I never did play Investigations.
It's good, but I don't really like the music that much. I was in pain. A horrible burning pain to my shoulder.
Also, Investigations 2 is never happening, people. Get over it.
Why must you be so cruel? I actually like that game. Shut up.
I did too, but Capcom's most likely never going to release it over here.
They can still put it on the eShop.
They could, considering that...
Or here's a better idea. Put it on the DS emulator on the Wii U. Yeah.
Oh, shit.
It's eventually coming. I swear.
We've been talking about it for weeks now. We've been talking about it for months now.
He was fooled. It was the perfect crime.
Nah, shit.
How was
or
it
was
perfect
it?
Crime?
He's all hey, rape face.
Who would have thought another man would have come to open that elevator door? Judge!
Eh?
Yes? Yeah, eh? What are you doing? Do your job, dammit! Bring it into this miserable charade! Now, end it!
Okay,
yes, sir.
Wow, even Karma just is like, just say that I'm guilty, goddammit!
Just say that I'm guilty so we can go home! I'll go home in time to play Smash.
Karma, you're not going home. What are you talking about? You're going to jail.
Fuck!
We don't have a Wii U in jail.
Fuck! This court finds the defendant, Mr. Miles Edgeworth, not guilty again.
Yay.
And I'm still here.
They should have put something underneath the not guilty. Just says again.
Didn't we find him innocent like an hour ago?
I think that was for the other case.
Okay, Edgeworth, I forgive you for incriminating yourself like a douchebag.
Indeed.
Anyway, it took 7.5 hours, but we're done.
Nick, we did it. You see his face? He looked even paler than usual.
What do you mean we, Maya? What did you do?
He did stuff.
That's true.
I gotta say, I'm impressed. It's pretty close, though. I was sure we'd had it. I know, I was on the verge of tears the whole time, myself. No, you weren't. Nah, it's all just a good memory. A good memory, yeah,
a good
I'm
memory.
Sure.
We convicted a man
a good
of
memory
murder.
Of stress!
And also unlocked a bunch of repressed memories for Edgeworth, which probably now scarred him even more for life.
Nah, oh, not really. This starts Edgeworth's character development.
It only Great. Takes till the very end of the goddamn game.
Takes very end of the goddamn series.
Yeah. I know, the time the third game comes around, he's actually freaking awesome.
But by the third game, his character development is done.
Yeah, by the third game, his character development's done because he's not very relevant anymore.
Spoiler, when he does show up in the third game, it's doesn't even
and
matter.
When he shows up in the third game, it's part of the flashback.
Where he's still a douche, where pre-character development, and you're just like, alright, he used to be like this.
Damn it,
Gumshoe. You pulled through just like I thought you would. I'll never forget this. I owe you for one. I'll give you a nickel as part of my paycheck.
I'll never forget this until the second game where I completely forget that you did this.
Yeah, my salary went down a bit this month, but who cares? Party's on me! Ramen for everyone!
Ramen. No, I just want to imagine, since I've already played the second game, like, I'll never forget this until the sequel when I completely forget about everything that happened in this game. And still think you're an asshole.
I'm pretty sure he had a lot of his mind on that time. Here's Edgeworth trying to be excited and failing.
He's like, I feel foolish.
I'm tsundere. I don't know how to not be tsundere.
I feel foolish. I'm trying not to be yandere, but I'm not sure if I'm doing it right. Hey, y'all, kill you! Why are you here?
Calm down, man.
God damn it, I forgot she shows up in the finale.
I will burn that afro off your skull.
Don't feel bad.
You don't deserve that afro!
It's okay, we'll never see her again until the next game, and the next... She's only in the next two games as an important... She doesn't represent every southern character in... She doesn't represent every southern person in the world, dude.
So yeah, remember when I was trying to freaking get you to a guilty verdict? Let's forget that.
Maybe this is how Japan thinks people in Southern America act like, but that doesn't mean it's true.
Hey, say, hey, remember that one time I tried to get you guilty over the Loch Ness Monster?
You mean that case that happened an hour ago? Yeah, that one!
Hi, Larry. My life is over again. Why the sad face, Larry? What happened now? Your girlfriend leave you again? I'm not long for this world. You don't look sick. It's Kansei. She's going to live in Paris. Paris, Nick! Of course. Hey. You leave me behind. Good for you.
Larry.
Too bad for your samurai dog, Stan.
That's alright. Yes, they weren't very good anyway. I sneezed on all the dogs.
And that stupid detective dog ate all my buns.
Good dog, Missile.
Paco slipped the dog a 20.
Missile works for Paco.
Sure, why not? Yeah, apparently King Paco can talk to dogs. Who knew?
It's got money!
Hey, that's not strange. People give money away to celebrate sometimes.
$38.
$38?! What a weird amount. I mean, it's not a little, but it's not a lot either.
He was just like, wait a minute. Exactly.
$38 exactly?
$38
exactly?
Oh, crap.
Nick! Was that exactly the amount of lunch money that was stolen from Mr. Edgeworth in school? $38! No.
Larry! Fucking Larry!
You son of a bitch! What are you so surprised about, right? Huh? Larry was absent that day from school, right? But that doesn't automatically rule him out as a suspect.
You're the one that ruled him out as a suspect, you fucker!
Think back to that day 15 years ago. Larry took the day off, but he was bored. He came into school anyway. Then he saw the money lying there, and the rest is history.
Fucking Larry.
I know it was good history.
Damn it.
God damn it.
Edgeworth, you didn't know, did you? You didn't know, did you?
I suspected.
I just couldn't picture Larry protecting you like he did that day. Everyone else was saying you did it. The whole class was against you, remember?
Yeah, too well.
Ouch. My life is a lie!
You may not know this, we had a saying back in school.
When something smells, it's usually the butts.
I know.
Oh, God. Really, right? I'm surprised you didn't figure it out.
Wow, burn.
This is certain unexpected events. Edgeworth. Yeah. You should have told me! You son of a bitch! It was 15 years ago.
He ruined my life!
If it wasn't for you, I'd have a better job!
I should get paid!
Leafy!
I can't wait to defense study because of what you two did!
You wanna know what I find hilarious?
Well, I tell you, Tootie Gucci shoes to the extreme.
You know what I find hilarious?
Yeah,
Larry pays Edgeworth, but not Phoenix.
The death sentence for both of you!
I know it, I've become prosecutor!
I'm sure Phoenix would have enjoyed even getting even the $38, but he gives the $38 to Edgeworth, not Phoenix!
I thought I might have killed my own dad. I thought I might be a crook. I became a prosecutor in part to punish myself. Why? That doesn't even make sense!
What the?
Seriously, that doesn't even make sense!
Edgeworth?
Okay!
Hey, wanna switch, right?
Yay! Line up, I'll take a photo!
No.
Photo time! Let's go! Do it now! And after that, do it on me! Ramen for everyone! The cheap $5 brand!
And then you realize, Gumshoe, once you give everyone ramen, you have absolutely no money left.
No!
Poor guy.
Edgeworth is still in detention. Fuck.
God damn it.
5 a.m.
Meanwhile, on December 29th.
Like the day afterwards, isn't it?
Oh, 5 a.m. Yeah. No, I'll never get back to.
I went a little overboard yesterday. I shouldn't have drank all that apple cider.
Apple. Yes, apple cider.
That's still considered alcohol.
Yeah, well, hard apple cider would be anyway.
Yeah.
That's what I meant. That's what I meant, the Angry Orchard brand, too.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Good morning, Nick. You were really impressive yesterday, but because I'm still in an emo phase, I'm going away forever.
Damn it, Maya!
That's really what it is!
What did you do to deserve leaving forever?
It's not what she did, it's more like what she didn't do.
Oh,
you did
accomplish pretty much nothing in this entire game.
Here's a cheerleader.
For the red-white case.
Cheerleader.
That's it.
Cheerleader. Throughout every single case, cheerleader. What time is it? First train from the mountains have already left. No! To the station! And now I'm throwing that in there.
Damn it!
God damn it.
Later, though. I guess I'm too late. .. Damn, Jay! Oh, God! Where'd you come from?
It's like, damn it, Maya, I'm trying to cry here! Wait a minute. Oh, right.
Maya, shut up, I'm trying to cry! Oh, wait.
Oh shit.
Will you get out of your? It's like, hey, will you stop going out of your emo face for 2 seconds?
Nevis.
That's bad for your health.
That's why I'm leaving.
That doesn't make sense. Where the fuck do you think you're going, bitch?
You're my partner. You're probably more popular than. No. Never mind. No.
You're like more popular. You're more popular than Lana. Let's put it that way.
But that's not very hard to do, Nick.
Okay, Gumshoe. You're more popular than Gumshoe.
That's not very difficult to do either.
The judge.
Really?
Why not?
But then
what are you talking about? Grossberg didn't do shit!
But in the next game, there'll be another character that's still more popular than me.
You're still there!
Like, God damn it!
God damn it, let me have my emo moment without you ruining it!
The sad thing is, I'm pretty sure the new character that's introduced in the second game is more popular than Maya.
Oh, you know she's not. Not even. Not even close.
I don't know. Maybe people like her, I don't know.
Take this bullet!
No, we're showing her how she helped.
Oh, right.
We're not giving her the bullet. Like, come on, Logic, seriously.
No, he just. What do you imagine if, like, he gave her the gun? It's like, who needs help when you have. Oh, God.
God damn it.
Why'd you pawn off your badge? For the same reason every American pawns something, to get a gun.
But it's your metal cookie.
Shit, you're right! I gotta get back! Alright, I'll be waiting, Maya. George Ball, you can't rely on us by yourself. You're freaking hopeless, you piece of shit.
Then why are you leaving? If you know that Wright can't run his own office by himself, why are you leaving?
Because, yes.
It's about as eventful as every single Tamagotchi kid in existence. They keep, every time they leave, they're like, alright, I'm off, bye. Bye.
He's actually crying.
Wow, we actually get to see a unique photo for freaking once.
Yay.
And so my story ends, until part two. Time to turn a new page, say goodbye to the novice defense attorney that I once was. Except I still am a novice.
assuming that Capcom actually continues the story in the right way.
Let's see, with now a new story where I get amnesia.
Assuming that Capcom actually does the same plot.
It wouldn't be surprised. Mr. Wright, perhaps you'd like to rethink your claim? Yes, Your Honor.
Shit.
Boosh. And that was Phoenix Wright, Ace Attorney, ladies and gentlemen.
Hooray!
Fuck.
And both of you are like, it's over! It's finally over!
We could have had this done 2 months ago, but things happened. We apologize.
Yes. Then he hung his head low and went right back outside.
That doesn't sound like that.
Kind of like he's embarrassed or something.
Strange, isn't it?
Shut up, Sonic.
Anyway, final thoughts, guys?
I love this game. This is...
Yes.
This is probably... Well, I wouldn't say it's my favorite, but it's pretty damn close to being my favorite in the franchise. It does a lot of things right, considering the style of game this is. It's actually a lot easier to play than I think most people would think it is.
It's definitely easy if you pay attention.
I mean, usually when people think of a game as a visual novel, they're usually turned off by it. But if you want to get into visual novels, this would be the perfect game to start off with.
Shut up, Payne. Nobody cares about you.
That's why you're in every game.
It's a tutorial boss for every single game.
That's my point. But yeah. Oh God, no.
Then there's his asshole.
Look at that face! I'm sorry, but it's creepy.
Mystic Manor!
Murder Manor. God damn it.
Yes, Murder Manor.
I mean, who else but him would be excited about the fact that there was a murder in a hotel that he worked at?
He's all Everybody. Money. Give me money.
Exactly, money.
Anyways, yeah, so as the first games go, this is really good. If you really want to get into Phoenix Wright, start with this game, because it's going to teach you everything you need to know. But without spoiling anything, every game from here onward is going to kick your ass left, right, and sideways if you don't know what you're doing.
Yep! Logic, you want to say your 2 cents?
Well, nothing that I can say is going to be any different from what Sire's already said. Pretty much that, as far as since this is the first game in the series, like, it is a very good starting point. But, like, the later two games, while they do get harder, they do get even more awesome in terms of, like, their, like, overall stories.
Yeah, that's true. Especially the third game. We'll get to that much later.
Oh, yeah, that one's, like, the craziest one of them all.
And what about you, Mr. I did all the recordings.
It took forever. And stop asking! No, I'm not doing the DLC! That'll take forever!
Yeah, case 5 takes way too damn long.
I'll give you a summary. Someone's a douchebag. Yeah, police chief's a douchebag. End of story.
Also, the reason why is because every case from the second game onward is just as long as case 5.
Yep, and that's why I'm not gonna fucking bother. Anyway. I think Capcom did a really good job developing the world of Ace Attorney. They turned something so stupid of an idea for a game, and then turned it into a really silly drama CD that made absolutely no sense, but you know what? Everybody loved it anyway. That's the entire reason Otakon has its own Ace Attorney panel, for, you know.
Are you gonna go to that?
Of course I am! I went before!
Apparently Cody got scarred for life from seeing who was under the Pink Princess costume.
Yep. Who wouldn't get scarred for life?
We'll never get away from Lada.
Hey, by the way, Lada helped Samurai Tacos go boom.
Shit.
They went pub. Samurai Tacos went public.
Oh, I'll throw in this too. If you don't want to play the game, you could always watch the movie.
Or just watch this run.
That too.
Yeah.
You know, that this run actually has every single case, where the other one only has, like, two.
Well, they kind of have the third.
Holy shit, ghost!
No wonder she became a paranormal photographer. Holy shit!
I should do this for a living!
Also, Maya, you were back holding in the sign sideways.
That was kind of the point. You can still read it. Back in the days when Capcom was good. We hope you enjoyed this. We hope you enjoyed this run of Phoenix Wright Ace Attorney, and we'll see you all in the future somewhere. Time.
Eventually, we'll get to the second game whenever Muiji feels like recording it.
Whenever one of you feels like it, because I'm not doing it. I don't know. I'll think about it.
If anything, maybe we should do that. Like, since you recorded the first game, me and Sire should record either the second or third game, so either one of us will record one game each.
That's a good point.
That's a good idea, because in all honesty, while I do have three games, I'm probably not going to sit through all of them.
Yeah, and it can get really tiresome recording the same kind of game three times in a row.
Indeed.
I call Trials and Tribulations.
Son of a bitch!